Fury!
Hello, and welcome to Game Theory. My name is Frost. This is a new series on DNN hosted by myself, where we focus on the sporting side of Donk Dank. Donk Dank Donk? Home? I think that's another one. Donk Ankerton? Seriously, pick a name. For our first report, we'll be looking into the new phenomenon known as Hoedown, and why some people will be using it to become a squire. Hoedown! Sport of peasants, champions, and male strippers. Popularized by Sanji Sama, the aforementioned stripper, a Maya 13, Tyler Neri, Blue 31, M1 Silencer, Rainbow Spirit, Fenar, Binju Sunday, Severy, and Beluga 09. Wow. The first Hoedown took place on August 8th, 2014. It's since then turned into a sensation that's been sweeping Donk Dank. Three tournaments, 161 applicants, 257 official matches, three champions, one squire? Flashback to a Hoedown tournament from the past. The External wins the second annual Hoedown and is asked by Lord Roman what he wants for his prize. He asks to be a squire, and his wish is fulfilled. He is sent to Friendship Town and is made a squire. Unfortunately for him, that didn't really last too long, but whatever. Now this raises some questions. What about Loveland Monkey? Ambitious Hobo? Why should they not be made a squire? They won the tournaments before, so it would seem fair. But more importantly, could anyone who wins the future Hoedowns be made a squire? We at Game Theory don't really think so, but do the peasants? Let's go to the big screen. It might give people the urge to compete in the Hoedown and give more endorsement.
I think it could pretty negatively affect the community to some extent. Being the champion, he should return for future matches and fight the winner. However, he can't do that if he's a squire, and as a ghost, he has an unfair advantage.
Well, I think for him being a squire, personally, it can have some, a little bit of intolerance for the other people who did not win. It could affect them that they feel discouraged to go on as Hoedown competitors and such.
I just want to say, he's one lucky person. We're unlucky for getting killed the next day, very next day.
I feel it will give lords an opportunity of getting new squires, and it will show talent.
Yes, very much so. People don't generally just want to be squire, just to be, like, a squire. They want to do it so they can have, like, fame, and they feel like they're special in a way, but it's not really how it's supposed to be.
I would think it's bad, since the people who just want to be a squire are not playing for the fun. They just want to win for the personal gain.
It's a community of people who test each other's skills by fighting each other with wooden hoes. And yeah, to see like which one's the best and everything like that, and see what they can improve on.
And some interaction with the with other districts where Hoedown can be for like shows, watching for lords to have fun with other peasants, and not so much about the squire competition whatsoever.
What if it did? What if you won the Hoedown? Congratulations, you're now a squire. What could it mean for the Hoedown? Well, for starters, people wouldn't be playing it for the love of Hoedown, or even for the money. They would be playing to become a squire. This would completely change the way Hoedown is right now. There would be an increase of players, sure, but the spirit and community that was built around Hoedown would collapse. There would be people who are only in it for the glory, and I'm sure there are lots of people who are against that. Now before I go any further, I've mentioned the spirit of the Hoedown. But what does that mean? Well, it can vary from person to person. Some might say they love it because of the atmosphere, the roaring crowd, the judging lords, two men beating each other with hoes. Others might say, in the famous word of Survivor's Eye of the Tiger, oh, others, well, they just like punching stuff. For me, it's about what people love about sports, underdogs, and uncertainty. You never know what's going to happen in a Hoedown battle. One second, you could be the champion. Next, you're being dethroned by a newcomer. One minute, you're defeated and down for the count. Another, you're back in and claiming a medal. Well guys, that about concludes it for this episode of the Lords of Minecraft Game Theory. Sorry for the length being so short. Tell me in the comments below how you feel about this and how I can improve it with some constructive criticism to help out with this new show. But don't worry for those of you who think I've forgotten something. Welcome to the Super Amazing End Card Tournament! The segment of the show where I ask viewers what they want to see for the next episode of Game Theory. Click the link on your screen right now to cast your vote for either Hardcore Parkour or Extreme Sport Fishing. Thanks for watching.